Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and that is a Snark Wildflower. It was manufactured in about 1979, and it's 11 feet long. I am going to put the sail on it and put it in the water for the first time in many years. I just acquired this little boat. Not much wind today, it'll be a perfect day to get out and give it its debut voyage. So, as I put it together, I will video it. The sail on this little boat is comprised of two sheets. A front sheet, small one, that's fixed. It's a jib sail. And then the second sheet, they call a lateen mounted sail. I don't know much about nomenclature on this stuff, but it forms a big triangle in the back, and it's the one that's able to be adjusted left and right. The mast is in two sections. By the looks of things, it's about 12 feet, maybe a little bit longer than that, but it steps clear at the bottom of the boat. So the first thing I need to do is get that mast stepped. All right, I'm sure it's more than a 12-foot mast now that I've got it together. One thing I'm going to tell you, if you're going to put one of these things together, make sure you run your rigging before you stand the mast up. I started to stand the mast up and realized there wasn't any way I was going to get to that top pulley to put the main sheet rope through it, or as far as that goes, even to put the little jib sail on. So think ahead, because otherwise you're tearing it all back down again. Whew. It's hot, it's muggy, sticky. Time to step the mast. The actual process of stepping the mast was quite simple. There's a mast step in the bottom. I hooked up the front cable and the side cable, stood the mast up, climbed in the boat, hooked up the other one. The mast is not very heavy, so it wasn't real difficult. The cables are not real tight. At some point I'll probably take a little slack out of the cables, but I think we're only running a couple mile an hour wind today, so shouldn't be any problem at all. Anyway, she's up. She's ready to put the horizontal mast on here, whatever you call that thing. Drop the rudder in, drop the dagger board down, and get her out on the lake. Well, there she is. I got her rigged. The sails, the pulleys, and everything are all hooked up. Now I'm going to put the rudder in, drop the dagger board down, and get her out here on this lake. Putter around. I'll let you know how it works when I get back. I sailed her to the other end of the lake and back. Took a long time because there's not much wind out here. As you can see, the mainsail's just hanging there. There's no breeze moving it at all right now. It's just up there. I'll walk around and see if we can get a picture of the other end. Let's see if we can get an idea. I sailed from this little boathouse here out around this corner. Mostly I paddled out here because there's no breeze in this corner. Down past the point down there on the right, and then you turn to the right and there's a dam about twice that far down the lake. And then I turned around and tacked back and forth across the lake. Each tack I gained about maybe 50 yards closer. And then the final run down here was almost full stream under this powerful 1 or 2 mile an hour wind. Most of the way in here, and then you can see, if you're looking at the reflections on the water, you'll see that all of a sudden here, the wind just stops. So then I just kind of coasted around the corner and back. I was probably gone a little over an hour. Good day, good day. Be nice to figure it all out on a little bit better wind day so I can get that jib sail set up properly, because I'm sure it would make a big difference. A couple times I got scooting along pretty good. It was enjoyable. Anyway, that's it for this video. Kevin Bacon.